So, the new budget flagship of MI is here. This is the new Redmi A1, the first Android One phone by Xiaomi. So in this video, we will be unboxing this phone and have a look in depth. Hey, what's up guys, this is Ayaz and you are watching Techno Vibes. So without wasting any further time, let's get started. So as you can see at the back of the box, there are some specifications like it has a dual camera setup with 2x optical zoom. Okay, it has a dual camera 12 plus 12 MP wide angle and a telephoto lens camera. And it doesn't run on MIUI OS, it has a pure Android OS, that is Android One. And it is powered by a Snapdragon 625 chipset and have a 5.5 inch display. Okay, for Indian price it has been set for ₹14,999 and I bought this mobile from Flipkart. Okay, in the box we get our first, this is the Redmi A1, the black color. Okay, and you can see at the bottom the Mi branding and the Android One logo, which has been placed at the bottom of the device. Okay, it looks similar to the Mi 5X, but the difference is only the Android One logo at the bottom. Keeping the device aside and looking towards the box contents, okay, in the box, the other content that we get is the USB charging cable. Okay, this is a USB-C type cable. And next in the box, we get other contents such as, okay, this is our charger. But this is not a turbo charger because it has a power rating of 2 ampere. And so this is not a turbo charger like we get in the Moto and all. And some manual contents, SIM ejector tool, but no cover or back cover as expected from the MI. So keeping the box content aside and looking towards the device now. So this is our MI A1, the first Android One phone by Redmi, and you can see the fingerprint is placed at the rear and the two camera setup with dual tone plus. At the right side of the device you get the power button and the volume rockers, and at the left side of the device you get the SIM card or SIM tool. Okay, at the top of the device you get the IR blaster as you can see in the most of the MI devices, and at the bottom you get the charging port, that is USB-C type, and a 3.5 mm headphone jack with speaker. The next let us remove all the plastic covers from the device. Okay, so this is a clear black display and it looks pretty good. So let's boot up this device and have a look at it. So this is the boot screen of the Android A1, and you can see the MI branding is also present at the bottom of the boot screen. So till the device gets boot up and I set up this device completely, let's have a quick look at the specifications. The MI A1 comes in 3 color variants, which is powered by Snapdragon 625 octa-core chipset clock at 2 GHz. It has 4 GB of RAM and 64 GB of storage, which can be expanded up to 128 GB. It has a 5.5 inch full HD LTPS display and 2.5D curved glass with Gorilla Glass protection for the first time, and it has a 3000 mAh battery. Talking about the camera, it has a rear 12 plus 12 megapixel wide angle telephoto camera setup with 2x optical zoom. You can have 4K video recording in it, and the secondary camera is a 5 megapixel shooter. The device has a rear fingerprint sensor with all other essential sensors like the proximity sensor, light sensor, gyroscope and etc. So my device has been completely booted up and I have set up all the things. Let's unlock this device with the fingerprint sensor. As you can see, it gets unlocked instantly, and you can see that it runs on fully Android custom stock Android OS. It's not a custom MIUI, and you can see it runs on Android 7.1.2 Nougat, but the device will be receiving soon the Oreo update as said by MI. And you can see that the buttons are backlighted, and you have a gesture control through fingerprint sensor. You can control your notification through the fingerprint sensor. Swiping towards the left, you reach to the Google Now instantly, and you have some pre-installed Google apps, but there are no Redmi or MI apps installed in it, but once you connect to the internet it will get downloaded instantly. Going towards the camera app, okay, you can see that this is the normal Mi camera app. This is not a Google camera app, and you have the one tap to zoom option. Let's first take some snapshot normally, which I'll be providing you in the video section later on. Okay, I turn this off, and you have a 1x or 2x optical zoom and one tap to zoom instantly through the app only. Just going back to the home screen, and you can see the recent panel. This is all about stock Android, and you can have that double tap on the recent button to go to the recent two of the recent app that you have used, and you can swap between them instantly. Dragging towards the app, you can choose the multi-window option, which is available in the Nougat, and this has been implemented by Google very earlier than the Xiaomi, which has provided in the Mi UI recently, who have updated their Mi phones to Mi UI 9, but the Google has implemented it very early. Next, going towards the camera app in detail, and you can see as you know, it doesn't have a Google camera. It runs it has a that typical Xiaomi camera app, and you get that optical zoom, 2x optical zoom and one tap to zoom option. You can see that many menus are present, like panorama, timer, audio, manual, straighten, beautify, and many more options of camera you get. I'm trying to take a snapshot. Yeah, the camera is pretty good, and the shutter speed is also too fast, and the one tap to zoom also works pretty well in this camera. And you have many options, and the pre-installed some filters in it which you can use in your photo shooting, like a black and white, analog, many filters are also present, like in the typical normal Xiaomi camera app. So this is that one. Okay, next, going towards the front camera, it has a 5 megapixel front shooter. You can see that I am recording with my Mi 3s through this phone, and this is I took a sample shot, and which I'll be showing you in the video section later. Going towards the video mode, you have a 4K video recording option, and the slow motion time-lapse video option is also available here. So you can record your videos in the slow motion also. So all over, this device is pretty good to in terms of looks, camera, and the performance, as it has been powered by a Snapdragon 625 chipset, and it has got a 4GB of RAM. And I think that this device would be a flagship killer in comparison to other devices among this price range of 15,000 rupees. So if you have a budget of 15,000 rupees, and you want a pretty good camera with a good performance, so you can have a better option, that is Redmi A1, in comparison to other mobile phones like Oppo and Vivo. So that's all for this video. Hope you like this video, so give a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. Have a doubt, you can comment us in the comment section below. This is Ayaz signing out. You are watching Techno.